wide disc for this to sit up. Just a second. Once the base sets up, once it's a little bit more solid, we'll do that. Want that on a gathering energy? By turning the iron nice and slow, the glass will naturally round up off the end of the iron. When she's ready, he's going to spool this glass on to the bottom of our vessel. Watch this, just turning the iron nice and slow. Spools the glass on there. Now to make that into a nice wide and flat foot, he's using a tool, we call it a footing tool, but it's basically two wooden boards that we're going to squeeze the glass together. This tool is not an easy tool to use. It's very easy to get the glass off center with this tool if not used correctly, but she's been doing this technique for quite some time now. Looks like he's got it down. Keep the bottom nice and flat. She's really working on the contour of the top of the foot with those wooden-bladed jacks, or steel-bladed jacks, rather. Alright, we'll work on the top half of this vessel, so I'll gather up just a little bit of glass on the end of a solid iron. This is called a putty, and in a moment, we're going to attach this putty iron right onto the bottom of the foot. Alright, so she can attach this iron. It's going to stick it right on the center. It's still a little warm, so he can move it around if he needs to. Just to make sure that this iron is running nice. So to break the glass free from the blow iron, she is going to stress the glass. Using a diamond bladed file, he's creating a score mark on the glass. This really weakens the glass right there. Just a small little tap, and this breaks free. All right. Did you like a paddle before doing that? So this is going to be the longest reheat of the show. In order to break the glass has to be in a solid state. So the glass was probably around 11, maybe 1200 degrees in order to break the glass free from that blow iron. And now we want the glass to be at a good working temperature, around 1800 degrees. So she is just localizing the heat on the top of her vessel. It's very important throughout the rest of the show that she doesn't let this glass get too cold. If the glass starts to cool too quickly, this will create a tension on the outside surface of the glass that's going to crack. What happens is as the glass cools, it shrinks. It's really unnoticeable to the human eye, but as we have the outside surface cooling down faster than the core of the glass, this means that the outside surface is shrinking faster than the core. That's what's going to cause the glass to crack. Using a tool called a steam stick, she's going to add some volume to the top of our vessel. This is just a wooden cone that we keep soaked in water. Now when the water on that cone comes in contact with the heat of the glass, provided that we have a nice seal right at the lip of the vessel, this creates some steam and that pressure just pushes the walls of the glass out. She's going to get rid of just a little excess. they must be wondering if we have to keep everything above 900 degrees, how do we save anything we make? The process is called annealing, so anything we make, we have to slowly cool down. A piece this size is going to take about 8 to 10 hours to do. By slowly cooling the glass, we give the thick and thin parts of the glass, the surface and the core of the glass, a chance to cool down evenly so that they shrink evenly. Would you like a power on this? So using a pair of wooden-bladed jacks, now called Karchovies, she will start to open up the mouth of our vase. We got a beautiful shape right there, but I think she's going to take it one step further. Simply by heating up the lip of the vessel and turning his iron a little bit faster, he will create centrifugal force. This is going to flare the glass open, kind of like a plate. It's really up to G how much he wants to flare the glass. And he can control that just by the amount of heat that he puts on the top of the vessel and the rate at which he turns.
Nice.
All right, so we are going to cool the glass down slowly now. We're going to anneal the glass. This looks like it'd be great for a Sunday.
I'm recording.
Big Sunday.
All right. A little tap. The glass breaks free.